Now, as we all know, we had studied this earlier, that after independence, the main objective of the government at that time was to make India a self-reliant country. For that purpose, what was necessary? It was necessary that we produce our goods, our own goods. We became self-sufficient in the field of agriculture, where we can feed our people on our own, in the production of goods that are required by the people. For that purpose, it was important to set up industries. Manufacturing industries needed to be set up. So for that purpose, planning commission was set up and plans were made. And according to those plans, the government worked to achieve its target. So we had at that time adopted a model of planned growth. Plans were made and according to that, the government followed its policy of growth. But policies that were adopted were very conservative in nature and they aimed at transferring the resources from the private sector to the public sector because it was felt that it is the government who can take care of the social needs in a better way than the private sector. It was the feeling that private sector will be profit motivated, they will work with the motive of earning profit and so they will not consider the social good at large. So it was the public sector that was given more preference. And all the policies that were made, be it the fiscal policies that the government made or the monetary policy that the RBI made or the foreign sector policy, everything was aimed at channeling the resources from the private sector to the public sector. We had a very protectionist type of environment in the early 70s and 80s. People who have lived in that era, they realized that at that time it was not a consumer driven market. It was a more of a supply driven market. The government had a very restrictive policy. It was just that you could manufacture only a limited number of goods because they wanted the resources to be directed towards more necessary things. Like they wanted the resources to be directed towards more infrastructure, building up of infrastructure. And so they wanted that consumer goods should be pursued less, like the cars and all. In 70s, if you wanted a car, you had to get it registered and within a year, after an year, you used to get your car. Or even a small thing, if you wanted a watch, you had to go to the shop, get it written, and then after 2 months you were given the delivery. So the production was also limited because it was restricted by the government. There was licensing policies and all. Because of that, the market did not grow. And slowly and steadily it was realized that there was a need of reforms which was needed because we were just not competent enough to compete with the global market as well as the increasing demand of the community. That was when it was needed that economic reforms became a necessity. The process was initiated in early 80s but not wholeheartedly and as a result it did not give any result. Then in the beginning of 1990s, we were in a deep crisis. The foreign exchange that was available was very low. It was just $1.1 billion foreign exchange left, which was just sufficient to pay for 3 weeks of import. So the forex reserve was very low. The burden of national debt was very high. Because the government was in order to carry out the expenditures that were there, they were continuously buying and borrowing. So the burden of national debt had also increased a lot. And because of the Gulf War and other conditions, the inflation was also very high. The prices were spiraling. So all these, because of all these conditions, it was and the external pressure of the world economy, it became very important to adopt the measures of economic reforms. So the then finance minister, Dr. Manmohan Singh, in the government of P.V. Narasimha Rao, introduced these steps, which was a major step in Indian economy. So economic reforms were introduced in the industrial sector, that is the manufacturing sector, in which all the manufacturing, which was very regulated, you needed a lot of licenses and all. So it was introduced in that sector, finance sector, which means the banking sector and insurance sector, external sector, which means the foreign trade sector, export and import sector, and taxation, which is the main source of income for the government. So in all these sectors, economic reforms were introduced in the year 1991.